This conference will now be recorded. This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, so just a second. Yeah, so internal table is a temporary memory. Internal table is a temporary memory which is allocated during the runtime to store the data which we are going to fetch from the right database table or which we are going to prepare in our program to further processing. So internal table, it's a temporary memory area. It contains the data during the runtime only, not the permanently. But the DB table, if we are going to compare the internal table with the DB table, this can also be an important interview question. Okay, what is the difference between internal table and DB table? Okay, so yesterday Ramesh was asking after the class. So let me write these differences over here. Internal table versus DB table. DB table means the database table. Database table means the table which we have created from the SC11, right? So that I'm talking mainly about. So here maybe you can write internal table, and here we can write the DB table. Okay, so internal table, it's a get stored in temporary memory. Okay, temporary memory during the runtime of the program. Runtime or session of the program. As soon as program session gets over, automatically content of the internal table gets deleted. Okay, gets deleted, and memory also gets deleted, and memory also, like whatever memory has been allocated by the internal table during the program, memory also gets cleared. On the other hand, the DB table, you know, it is not a temporary memory. It is stored in the permanent memory. Okay, it's stored in the permanent memory. That's why you can access anytime you can access permanent memory, not only during the program session. Okay, here, like internal table, you cannot create through the SC11. Okay, internal table cannot be created through SC11. So you can find out many differences, but this is the main difference. Actually, this is the main difference. Even after, you know, after your session is going to get terminated, that DB table still will be there, right? Even after session termination, you know, or session completion, okay, your session is going to complete or terminate, you know, even after session termination or compilation, it is not going to affect on the DB table. DB table always exists. So it's a permanent. DB table is the permanent, internal table is temporary. That is the big difference. Okay, after that you can write many differences, right? Internal table cannot be created through SC11, you know. Then here DB table can be right, DD, data dictionary table, right? Data dictionary table or table. When I tell this data dictionary table, I mean DB table, database table. Okay. DD table can be created, you know, through SC11, right? Again, you can find out many differences. There are three different types of internal table, right? You are having three different types of internal table. What is that? First is a standard one, a standard internal table, right? The second one is sorted internal table. We have already discussed this, right? A standard internal table, particularly, we have to still discuss about the sorted internal table and a hashed internal table. Hashed internal table. So this you have, right? And here you have three types of DB table, right? One is transparent table, pool table, and cluster table, right? So these are the different types of DB table. Here you have the technical settings, right? Here you don't have any technical setting kind of thing. Here you don't have any, no technical setting, no technical settings, right? So these are some differences, but the very important difference is, you know, the internal table, the first one difference, right? It's a temporary, just remember this one, that will be enough. Okay, temporary. And the second one is the permanent. It's a permanent. Okay, fine. Let's go ahead. And so this we have done, fine. And we also saw yesterday, like what is a binary search, what is sequential search, and what is index-based search, like directly through index, how we can access the table. And you know, the time consumed by the index-based search is very less, you know, then binary search take little more time, and then the sequential search depends where the record is there, right? If it is there in the beginning, it will take very less time, even less than binary search, right? But if it is recorded at the last, it's going to take lot time. So overall, if you see the performance, you know, the maximum time is going to taken by the sequential search if the record is at last. If the required record, you know, if the required record is at last, required record is at last, then it's going to take the maximum time. Then the binary search and the index search, right? And here its complexity is going to be log, you know, of n is the number of records, and base will be 2 over here. We have discussed these things yesterday. And here the index based search, you know, it's a very, very fast, and it's a constant for each record, constant for each record, whatever the it's a record in beginning or at last, it does not matter, it's going to take the same amount of time. Okay, the index, because you are already telling to the system that go and get this record. Fine. Okay, let's go to the system and go to the program, going to change mode. And here we have seen yesterday that we are going to, okay, let me do one thing. I will I will open my OneNote. Just give me a second. I'm going into the syllabus where we have written everything about training 20th. Yeah, so here you can see that, you know, we have multiple operation, right? Append we have completed, just I am marking down, right? Insert also we have seen, sort we have seen, right? I'm just going to tell you about sort we have seen, the read table with key, with sequential and binary search both we have seen. For binary search you must have to sort the table, right? Read table with Windex also we have seen. Loop end loop I have to show, modify, delete, all these things. All other I have to tell. Let's start with the describe table. Okay, come over here. What is the meaning of describe table? So describe table is nothing but, suppose if you have to find the number of records in an internal table. Okay, suppose if you have to find the number of records in an internal table, how you are going to find. So here you can see, with the help of append statement, first I am pipping the work area and then I am appending to this IT underscore Mara. Similarly, second record I'm preparing into this IT underscore Mara by preparing the work area, and then third, fourth, and like that I'm preparing. So here at last we are having this IT underscore Mara is my final table over here, and I want to see that how many total number of records are here at this point of time, right? Suppose if I want to identify total number of records. So how you can do that? You can first declare one variable so that you can get the number of records. You can put the number of records in this variable. So lv underscore count type I you can give over here, and you know, here you can give this syntax describe table and it underscore mara into describe it underscore mara to, I think, no, simply you have to give lv underscore count. I think this is not the correct syntax. Describe table it underscore mara lines actually we have to give over here, lines. Okay, describe table means just I'm telling to the system, describe this it underscore mara table in terms of how many lines. Okay, so how many lines that will get stored in this lv underscore count variable. This lv underscore count already I have declared. So the number of record, whatever will be there, that will get stored in this. And this we can print it over here. Lv underscore count, if you want to print this, you can print. Activate this one and put the breakpoint over here. Run this. Some problem is there, right? It is telling, let us see what is the problem. Error in ABAP statement, processing an internal table. All these things is coming. Let us see some loop after delete. So how you can analyze the, you know, dump. Suppose if we're going to analyze the dump, how you can analyze. So it is telling over here, what is the dump? You know, the what happened, it will tell. There is a some statement which could not be executed. That's why it has given the dump. But where is the problem, right? So you can see once, or directly, you know what you can do, just drag, keep on going down, and you will see at which place it has given you the dump. Here you can see at this particular place it is giving the dump. Why it is giving the dump? By looking into this statement itself, you can identify that why it's giving the dump. Okay, for the insert statement I am not using any index over here, so the system is giving the dump. So I will just quickly go back and I will correct that part, or I will simply comment. Okay, so some insert statement is there, index, that's fine. Here also you can specify some index, so it will not, so it will not give you, you know, it will not give you any dump. So some valid index you can give over there. Let's, and you can realize that at the runtime, while checking the syntax, it's not giving any error, but you know, at the compile time, while checking the syntax. That means while compile time, it is not giving any error, but you know, once we are running this program at this time, it's giving the error, but now it will not give, right? Because I have corrected. So if you have not specified any index for the insert operation, you know, it will not give any error at the runtime, at the compile time, but it will give you the error at the runtime. Runtime means when I'm going to run the program. Okay, here you can see in this IT underscore mara, I just want to see how many total number of records is there. So I'm double clicking over here. You can see there are total 6 number of records, but this 6 I want to get into a variable in the program. So this is the syntax. Okay, so press F5 and you will see in LV underscore count 6 has come over here, all right? And this is how this describe table you can use. Okay, so press F8 and you will see the 6 has come over here. Okay, fine. So this is the describe table, and then loop end loop. What is this loop end loop? So loop end loop is nothing but one by one record if you want to access. Okay, one by one. I'm just going to comment all these things. I don't require this point of time all this. Okay, let's make it little simple. Okay, come over here and loop. So loop end loop, I'm going to use it over here. So loop, how you can use this one, loop at. So what it will do, this loop, one by one it will get the internal table. Okay, one by one it will get the record from the internal table and it will put into the work area. So it's an iterative statement with the help of which what you can do, for example, suppose you are having a MATNER over here, you are having the MTART, you are having the MBRSH. MATNER is 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. MTART, you are having row, 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 and let's suppose this is the FEIT, and I'm just preparing some data over here. Okay, so this is our data in the internal table. Okay, this is the data in the internal table I'm having. This is my header, and what I want, what I want, one by one I want to print this one. Or if you want to access the record one by one in sequence, first you want to access this particular record and you want to do anything, anything you can do with this record. Now one by one you can access and you can do anything. Again, the second record I want to access. Okay, and again the third record I want to access and I can do. So in sequentially I want to do, I want to access the record. So for this purpose, what I will do here, I will write the loop at IT underscore mara. Let us suppose this name of the table, the IT underscore mara, into I will write the work area. So my work area is this one. So what I will do, when I will write this statement loop at IT underscore mara into work area, so it will put the loop on this particular internal table and one by one it will copy the data and it will put into this work area. Okay, again the second record it will put into the this the same work area in the second pass of the loop. Okay, in the third pass of the loop, again it will copy and put in the same work area. Again in the fourth pass of the loop, it will copy and paste in the same work area, and whatever you want to do you can do. Okay, whatever you want to do you can do, and once the record gets completed it will come out from the loop. Okay, it will come out from the loop. So I'm just going to show you over here, just I want to print the data of the internal table. So I will use the help of this loop. So loop at IT underscore mara into WA underscore mara. So the work area should be compatible with the internal table. Okay, so the type should be the same, you know. So TS underscore mara here for this internal table also I have taken the same type, and for the work area also I have taken the same type. Both is referencing the same type, you can see over here, right? So that means both is compatible, then only the data will get copied from here into here properly. Okay, and every loop you must have to end with the end loop. So most of the statement in ABAP, like when you are going to start, for example, like if, then you have to use the end if, right? If you're going to use the if, then you have to use the end if. Similarly, you know, when you are going to use the while loop, there also you have to use the end while, like that. Similarly, most of the statement you are going to end with, you know, the statement which you are going to begin following with end. Okay, so you can come over here, and now what I want to do, I want to print the content of W underscore Mara. So I will just write over here, right? Write over here. And but maybe first I will show you how this loop is going to get behave. Check the syntax, activate this, activate it, put the breakpoint over here, press F8. Okay, so in W underscore Mara, you can see currently there it will be let us see, some record is there in W underscore Mara. Okay, because I have not cleared this W underscore Mara. So whatever the last record it was there in the work area, that it is taking. So that's why before using any work area, yesterday I have told you that we are supposed to clear the work area before using. So I'm just going to use clear WA underscore Mara. Here I'm using this work area, right? So I'm just going to clear it before using. Activate this one, again run, and this time you will see this W underscore Mara will be blank. Okay, so WA underscore Mara, double click over here, and you can see there is nothing in this W underscore Mara. Now press F5, right? And in IT underscore Mara, you are having 6 records over here, 1, 6, 2, 5, 3, 4, like that you are having the record, right? So here just press F5 and you will see the first record of this internal table will get copied into this work area. So the first record, one row one, will get copied where? Into this work area, one row one. Similarly, this is the first loop pass. This is the first loop pass, first time only it has been executed. So in the first loop pass, no, where is the control of the program on which record? So you can see in this internal table, your program is pointing to the first record. So whatever the record program is pointing, that gets stored in a system variable called site tabix. Okay, that gets stored in a system variable called site tabix. So you can see the one is here. That means site tabix means system is currently pointing to the first record. That's the meaning of site tabix, first record. So tabix, you can see the tab, right? Tab means it is related with, that means this system related with, you know, actually tabix full form is tab index. Okay, tabix full form is table index. So currently, at the current point of time, the program is pointing to which particular internal table record, that is being tilled by this site tabix system variable. Come over here, go back, and in the second pass, right, again the control has come over here. You can see the little cursor over here, the arrow. Okay, and when I press F5 again, you can see the site tabix become 2. That means program is going to, you know, point the second record. Okay, so the second record will get copied from here into the work area. Just go back and you will see the second 6FEIT6. This is my second record, it just got copied into the second in my work area. Similarly, the third record will get copied. Okay, what is the third record? Third record is 2ROH2. So if you see in W underscore Mara, 2ROH2 is there. So six time it will done, and after six time it will come out from the loop. You can see the site tabix has become now 6. That means it is pointing to the last record, because the total number of record in my internal table is 6 only, right? So you can see here now the pointer has been to the last record, 4FEIT4. Okay, and now what it will do, it will come out from this loop because it has reached to the last statement. So it will come out from this particular loop statement. Okay, and if you press F8, just will come out. If you want to do anything over here, because one by one you are getting the record into this, and now you can use the right statement to print the data. Okay, so Matner W underscore Mara hyphen MTIT comma W A underscore Mara hyphen MBRSH. Okay, so this you can use. Okay, pretty printer, check the syntax, activate this one and just press F8 and you can see the record is coming like this. It is printed now, but it is printing sequentially. The reason behind, I have not given a new line. Okay, so after each loop pass, my record should be printed in the next line. So you have to give this command over here, new line. This is called new line syntax. Okay, so now all these three record will be printed one by one, one by one, one by one. Press F8, press F8, press F8, and you can see now one by one the record got printed over here. So this is how you can use this write statement. One thing you might observe over here, you know, after this write, or here many times, you know, many times I'm using this colon, this colon, this colon. What is the significance this colon actually? This colon is known as a chain operator. Okay, this colon is known as the chain operator. Okay, so with the help of same write statement, you can print over here the three different variable, right? These are the three different variable. If we're not going to use this colon, it will not allow to print all these three at one time. What you will have to do, you know, what you will have to do, first I will show you, it will not allow you. You can see the red color is over here. You can check the syntax, you can see it is telling you the problem over here. You are getting the problem, right? If you're not using this chain operator, this colon. So if you don't give that one, then in that case, what you will have to do, you know, you have to use three different write statement. You will have to use three different write statement. You will have to use. If you are not going to use the chain operator, in that case, you will have to use three different write statement. You can see over here, 3, 1, 2, 3, 3 different write statement, and now it's not giving any error, and it will produce you the same output. Okay, it will produce you the same output, right? But with the help of single write statement, if you want to write all these three, what you can do, that you can, I'm just going to comment it. I will keep it for your reference. So I'm just going to comment and I will paste it like this. Give the chain operator this colon, and with the help of single write statement itself, separated with comma, now W underscore Mara hyphen MTART, as we have written earlier, we can do. So that's the meaning of, you know, chain operator. That's the meaning of chain operator. Sometimes in interview, they may ask to the freshers. They may ask to the fresher. So hope it's clear for you, and activate it and just press F8, and you can see that you are getting the same output over here, right? Just go back, and I'm just going to remove this breakpoint now. If it will be required, I will again enable. Come over here in syllabus and loop and loop, I have told you, right? And one thing maybe I can tell you at this point of time itself, you know, if first pass of the loop itself you want to get exit, yesterday I was telling you, right? So site tabix you can do over here, like if site tabix, or suppose after second pass or third pass of loop itself you want to get exit from this loop, so you can, you can, what you can do, can any one of you tell me what I will have to write over here?
Exit statements.
Yes, we have to write the exit over here, so it will just come out from this loop, and whatever, you know, whatever you are going to write it over here, suppose you are going to write test, it will come to this particular means it will come to the next, it will not directly come out from the program. Yesterday we have already seen, again once again I'm just trying to show you, and maybe some another important stuff also I can show you over here, right? So here you can see the site tabix equal to 3. In the third pass of the loop, this condition got true and system has come over here on this exit statement when the condition got true, right? And so the first two has already printed over there in the output area, okay? But when Sitefabric third came over here, you know, it is coming to this exit. So press F5 and you can see it will come out now. You can see it has come out, right? And press F8, you can see that only two records got printed and at last I has written tests. That's why this test is printing over here. Now, suppose, you know, suppose this three is there, right? So after this three, you know, when three is going to come, let's suppose for five, I want to get exit, okay? But my requirement is something like that. For record number three, suppose you have written some logic over here, right? For example, you know, this logic, this printing, you want to, let me show you one thing over here. Printing, activate. At this point of time, it's printing all these things, right? Let me remove this test from here, activate now. And at this point of time, it is telling you all this record over here, right? What I want to do that I want to print only the record number, only the record number 1, 2, 3, 5 and 6, like that I want to print. I want to, I don't want to print the record number 4, right? I don't want to record the, I don't want to print the record number 4. So what I can do here, if Sitefabric, okay, equals, you know, 4, in that case, and if in that case, I will simply continue. I will simply write over here the continue command I will give to the system. I will tell to the system that don't go ahead. If Sitefabric is 4 is there, just continue, means just go to the next loop pass. You don't have to go further and print this right statement. From here itself, this control will come over here. It will not come out, but simply it will, you know, simply it will go to the next cursor, next record it will go. I will tell you over here, this press F8, and you can see here only, you know, the 1, 6, 2, 3, 4, it is showing you. Maybe I will put the breakpoint over here and then I will show you. Press F8, okay? And here the Sitefabric is 1 at this point of time, so it will come, and F6, and you can see here, and as soon as the 4 will come, you can see now Sitefabric is 4. So when Sitefabric 4 will come, it will come with continue, and it will now not come to this right statement, okay? It will directly come to this loop. So the fourth number record will not get printed. If you want to see the fourth number record, you can see currently your fourth number record is 5FEIT5. So in output, you will be able to see that 5FEIT5 will not be there. Okay. You can see the 5FEIT5 is not there. Other is there. Okay. So like that, you can use this continue statement. Okay. Like that, you can use this continue statement. Now, exit. You understood, then continue, you understood, okay? Fine then, these are the two important one we have covered. The modify, delete, we will see how the modify is going to work over here. Okay, let's go here and suppose I want to modify some record. So let me do one thing, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? And this insertion, I'm just going to comment it so that we'll be having the proper data set. Okay, so in sequence, in this way we'll be having the data in the sequence, right? Activate this one. Okay, now my requirement, let's define our requirement first and we will see how we can do that one. So in IT underscore Mara, you can see over here that 1, 2, 3, 4 we are having. Now, what I want to do that, you know, I want to modify a record. Let's suppose this material number 2, I want to modify. I want to modify this material number two. Here for this material number two, I want to, you know, I want to keep this MTRT ROH, okay, ROH and MBRSH. Let's suppose I want to keep it one, okay. So here for this MATNR2, I want to at place of ROH, I will put FEIT, and for MBRSH, I will put one. This is my requirement. I want to modify, in fact, the second number of record. So what I will do first, I will prepare a work area, what I am going to, you know, modify, and then I will just modify it. So come over here, this loop and all. I'm just going to comment at this point of time. Let's first see how modify is working. So let's prepare on work area. Okay, I will use this one. Copied, I will paste and comment. So the second number of record I want to modify, so I will put it over second, and the MTAT I want to give FEIT, and MBRSH also I want to put it over there one. Okay, this is my requirement for the second. Earlier second is what, two. Second number record, you can see I'm preparing two ROH and two. I want to mark two FEIT and one. So now what you can do, that, you know, modify, you can write over here, modify what table, IT underscore Mara, we are having the table, this internal table I want to modify from WA underscore Mara, where MATNR equals to two, right? Like that you can modify the record. So wherever the MATNR equal to two is there, this IT underscore Mara get modified, whatever the content is there available in this W underscore Mara. So it's a very simple, you can see here, modify, I'm telling to the system, modify this internal table from W underscore Mara. From means whatever the data is there in W underscore Mara, with that content you modify this internal table where MATNR equal to two. Either you can specify where MATNR equal to two, or else you can directly give the index over here, index two. You know that already you have to modify the index two, so you can give like this also. So both the syntax will do the same thing. So you can use the modify statement in two ways. Okay, I'm going to show one by one. First I'm commenting the second one, and I will show you the some error is there. Let's see what is the error. Unable to interpret possible this. Okay, modify IT underscore Mara from, okay, I think here you have to write table, let us see. But where is not supporting at this point of time. Modify, unable to interpret where possible cause of error include incorrect spelling or comma errors. Okay, let me check with the single quote, is it? I don't think so, it will go. Okay, so it does not support the where statement. You can see here it's giving me the error. I just forgot the syntax. I get sometimes confused with the DB table and the IT Mara table, because the syntax for both is almost same to modify. When I will come in the chapter called DB table operation, actual DB table operation which we have created from SE11, there also we'll see the syntax something like this only. Okay, so no problem, you have F1 over here available. Select this modify and press F1, you will get all the possible syntax. Here this is the database table which I'm talking about, and this is the internal table, this we are talking about here currently. So click on this modify I tab, and you can see the what is the possible syntaxes it can have. So modify I tab line, all these things you are having here, you can see directly I tab from value, right? We are having directly, you can get the so modify table you have to give, and from value. But let me see this. This is the hash table. I'm talking about the internal table, the simple, you know, the standard table. I'm trying to tell you how you can do for the simple internal table. No worries. Let's leave it. I think it does not support, because here we are going to give only the where condition, and MATNR is not a key field, right, over here in this internal table. So that's why the system is not able to interpret if this is a key or what. So that's why. So here only the possible way you are having, you know, that modify it underscore mara from w underscore mara index two. This is going to work over here. Okay, this is going to work over here. Here you can see there is no problem. Modify this from w underscore mara index two. So this internal table will get modified, whatever the content is here at the index two. Okay, activate this one, that's fine. Press the cursor over here and F5, you can see the size of RC is zero. If modification gets successful, size of RC will be zero. Okay, if it is not successful, it will give you some non-zero value. Okay, and now you can see in this IT underscore Mara second, FEIT one has come. Earlier second, ROH two was there. Okay, so this is how it will get modified. Now you might be thinking, every time do you have to give this, you know, index every time? So see, without index you all, if you directly try to modify this internal table, it will give you the error again. Check the syntax, and here you can see an implicit index was specified to modify and all. It is just giving the warning at this point of time, but when you will run this program, it will go into dump. Okay, just press F8 and press F6, you can see it is going into the dump. Okay, so you must have to specify the index in case if you are having the normal internal table, that means the standard internal table. When you are going to use the modify statement, you must have to specify the index like this. Now generally you will get very less requirement where you have to modify some internal table with the help of an index like this. Generally you are going to modify the internal table inside a loop. Okay, so let me enable this loop over here. Okay, and here I will show you. So here if we are going to use this modify statement, okay, if we are going to use this modify statement over here, I'm just going to comment it now. And here if we're going to do, you know, this modification by preparing this suppose like this IT underscore Mara, let me tell you the scenario over here, put the breakpoint over here. Here you will see it will not give you any problem. Okay, it will not come into the dump. Why it will not come into the dump, I will explain it over here. You can see that when I'm putting it inside a loop, it is not coming into the dump. It is not giving any dump. It will not give you any dump. Why? The reason behind, in loop, if we're going to put implicitly, it will system put the index over here and site tabix. Implicitly at the kernel level, the ABAP runtime, what it will do, it will put the index and it will take the site tabix, means whatever the current record is there, that it will take into the picture. So that's why you are not getting the dump. Okay, so implicitly it will consider by the system this particular things. Okay, you can, I will just keep it that in a comment so you will be able to remember it. I'm just going to remove it, check the syntax, activate this. And suppose if you want to, you know, modify all the internal table material type, you know, W underscore Mara, let's suppose Mara hyphen mtart equals to everywhere, if you want to keep the FERT, right? Currently what you are having, I will show you. Press F8. So here you can see currently in this IT underscore Mara, what you have, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, ROH, ROH, FERT. Now what I want to do for all this material number, I want to put this material type only. Okay, FERT, I want to put FERT. So that's why what I'm trying to do inside the loop, because for each record I have to do that modification. One by one I will get the record value in this W underscore Mara, and their material type I will change whatever the existing from that to the FERT. Okay, so now you can see the IT underscore Mara was having the first material, what, ROH, right? So when the first material got copied into W underscore Mara, currently it was ROH But because of this assignment, FEIT, I'm assigning into this MTERT, so that ROH became FEIT. And now if we're going to modify, it will just modify the first record. Why? Because the index site tabix implicitly it will be taken care. So whatever the first record, whatever the record number it is going to access, that particular value is going to get accessed. So site tabix is one, that means the first record, it will modify the first record. Okay, so come over here and you can see in this IT underscore Mara, the first record it got modified with the FEIT. Now you are having the second record. Okay, so go here, press F5, because the right statement is here. Now come over here, the second pass of the loop. Okay, you can see the second pass of the loop. So in the second pass of the loop, W underscore Mara is having two ROH and two. Now, if you will come back, the MTERT value, right? Currently it is ROH. You can see. Let me close all these things. And currently the MTERT value is ROH, right? The individual component also you can access in this debugger. So W underscore Mara, all value, you can see the two ROH and two is there. Now what I want to do, I want to put in place of ROH, I want to put FEIT. So just I'm assigning this FEIT over there. So you can see here FEIT come for this MTERT instead of ROH. Now this modify statement will modify, right? Now this is modify statement will modify this IT underscore Mara. And where it will modify? It will modify at the second place. Why? Because the site tabix is two. That means currently the control of this loop is at the second record. Means it is accessing the second record into this W underscore Mara. So whatever the record it will access, the same record it will get modify. And that's why 99.99% time you are going to use this modify inside this loop. Okay, inside the loop. But again, if you have the large amount of record, suppose 1 million record is there, would you like to do this? Suppose you have 1000 record, 2000 record, that's fine. It's okay, you can use this one modify. But you have millions of record, 50,000, 40,000, 20,000, like that record is there. This modify is not record. This modify is not suggested to be used inside a loop. Okay. We have to use the concept called field symbol. We have to use the concept called field symbol. We will see that one in some another chapter, okay, or in some coming session, that how we are going to use the field symbol to modify an internal table record. Okay, very fast. That will improve your performance a lot. As a ABAP developer, you have to take care of performance a lot. Okay, so some 1000-2000 records is there, that's fine. But if you are having 10,000-20,000 records, large amount of records, you know, you are not supposed to use this modify from the work area. You are supposed to use the field symbol. That concept we will learn in the coming session. Fine, but this is also frequently getting used, this modify, if you have the small amount of data, right? So modify, you understood. Similarly, if you want to delete someone, right? So for deleting also, right? If you want to delete some record, if you want to delete some particular, you know, IT underscore, suppose this delete IT underscore Mara, and here, you know, this W underscore Mara is there, right? So for deleting, if you are not giving over here anything, what it will do, you must have to, in fact, if you are going to give this delete statement outside of this loop, you know, outside of this loop, you must have to specify the index. You must have to tell the system that which particular index you want to delete, which particular record you want to delete. So suppose I want to delete the record number three. Okay, I want to delete record number three. So come over here in IT underscore Mara, and you can see we are having four, and I want to delete the third one. So I'm just giving the index three over here. Press F5, and you can see the one record, the three got deleted, only 1, 2, 4 is there, right? So this is what I want to do. Now here, you know, inside the loop, here if you don't give the loop, again it will give you the error, that dump. The dump it will give, you can see it's giving the dump, right? Because I've not given the index. But again, for this, inside the loop you are going to give, you know, like this it underscore mara. Okay, if we're going to give this it underscore mara, it will not give you any dump. It will not give you any dump. Okay, it will not give you any dump. It will work. So what index it will take here? Implicitly it will consider what index. Can you tell me? I have just told you what index it will take. Yes, implicitly it will take sitetabx. Very good. So whatever the current record it is accessing through the loop, that same record will be accessed. Okay, so just activate now and put the breakpoint over here, press F8. I don't know, you can see I'm explicitly giving the sitetabx, right? Explicitly I'm giving the sitetabx. Okay, so it's just deleting the first three record. It has deleted already, you can see in this it underscore mara, only one record is there. Total four was there, right? And in case of four, you know, you can see the four also it will in case of four, why it has not come over here? Okay, fine, because in sitetabx four was there, I have just continued, right? Sitetabx four, in case of sitetabx four, I've just continued, and when it has come over here, right? So the sitetabx, so actually, you know, if you see here the sitetabx, you can see here the sitetabx, it is keep on changing. The sitetabx will keep on changing, right? That's why maybe you can see the 1 2 3 4, still you were able to see this 1 2 3 4. You might be thinking already record got deleted, then how it is coming over here? So you don't have to you don't have to get surprised. The reason behind the index, when we are going to delete, the index is going to be changed, right? When we are going to delete some record, the index will be changed, correct? I will show you how it's going to behave over here. Okay, so I'm just going to comment this part, activate it, press F8, and the first iteration, just see on the first iteration, it underscore mara, you are having four records over here, right? 1 2 3 4, ROH, FEIT, all these things is there, right? And 0 1, the first record is getting accessed. So if you press F5 over here, the first record got deleted, right? The first record got deleted, right? In the it underscore mara, the first record got deleted. And in w underscore mara, what you have? W underscore mara, so that getting deleted, but I'm printing over here in W underscore mara. I'm not deleting the record from the W underscore mara, right? So the system will come and it will print over here whatever the record over here, W underscore mara, it will print. So that's why it is printing. Okay, come over here, and again the second record will get deleted. So you can see the only two record is there. So in it underscore mara you are having two, right? So again, W underscore mara content is there. I'm not deleting W underscore mara content. I'm deleting the internal table content. So it will print, and that's why record is getting printed. So ultimately, if you see that, you know, all the it underscore mara will get deleted, and you can see all the four record got deleted, and there is nothing, right? There is nothing. So this is how, you know, this is how it's going to work, the delete. If you don't give the index again over here, automatically it will take care of the current access index, and it will, you know, it will delete all the record. Okay, so press
Pankaj.
Pankaj. Yes.
Please explain that to modify with the transporting means it specific wheels we can transport now. Only there are three wheels we can modify. Mm-hmm. Only using transporting,
right. Okay, we'll see that one. Yeah, I will go on to that part. Okay, so come over here, and you can see that delete, it's it underscore mara, though I have not given any index automatically. Yes, I will do that. Okay. IT underscore Mara, you can see 4 FEIT and 4 is there, right? Got deleted everything without specifying the index, and now IT underscore Mara is 0. So if you don't specify the index, also it will work in the same way. Similarly, to modify, delete, and insert also will work in the same way. Okay, you can just try this yourself. If you don't specify, it will not give any dump. If you don't specify, it will not give you any dump. Do not have a header line. Okay, insert into IT underscore or insert to into insert W underscore Mara. Insert W underscore. Just a second. Insert from, you have to write over here W underscore Mara. Okay, check the syntax. Insert or what is the syntax for this? I think into you have to give, no, insert table, is it?
No, insert work area.
Work area
into.
Insert work
area
into
table.
Yes, insert WA underscore Mara into table IT underscore Mara. Yes, right. Thanks. So check, now it is fine. So it will again not give you any dump because implicitly it will take index in the same way for delete and modify. Okay, so now let's go ahead. And the one thing that, suppose if you want to, you know, modify, there is a syntax called, means there is a requirement called, suppose, you know, let me define the requirement first. Come over here and I will show you desktop and IT underscore Mara. This four record you are having, right? In this four record you are having. So now what you want to do, that from a work area, you have prepared one work area. Okay, in that work area you are having the MTRT as FEIT and this MBRSH as one in that work area, but you want to only modify this material type. Okay, you don't want to modify this MBRSH. Okay, so what actually I'm trying to tell over here, what happened, it has gone into infinite loop, it seems, because, okay, come over AC38, because we have used the insert statement over here, so it has gone into the infinite loop. Okay, it has gone into the infinite loop because every time the index has keep on changing, that's why it has gone into the infinite loop and it has stopped over there. Okay, you can try all this, you know, all this experiment yourself. Come over here slash n sc38 and go into change mode, and now come once again. Okay, so W underscore Mara, I'm just going to define over here. So already we have defined, maybe I can use this W underscore Mara. And what I want to do over here, modify IT underscore Mara from WA underscore Mara index, let's suppose 2 at the second index. I want to do transporting, you know, transporting only some particular fields. Okay, transporting some particular fields. So maybe transporting what we can give that WA underscore MTART. Okay, so like that I want to do. Let me check, but there is a component similar. Okay, I think we have to give only MTIT. Check the syntax. So only what I want to do, I want to modify this MTART. Okay, I don't want to modify this MBRSH. Okay, put the, activate this one. Let us say if it's going to work properly or not. Press F8 and here, you know, Yeah, it's working fine. So maybe I will show you once again. I will go and this insert. I will remove from here, or in fact, I will remove all this thing over here. Activate this one. Okay. Come once again, press F8. Go to this w_mara, and here you can see you are having 5 FEIT and 5 this w_mara. Now in IT_mara, what you want to, at the second place you want to put here 5, and here you want to put, you know, MTEIT, and here you want to put, you know, 1. Sorry, here you want to put FEIT, in fact FEIT, and here you want to put 1 at the second place. But you know, so for that purpose you simply would have written, you know, without this transporting mTOR, that would have been done. Everything will be written with w_mara. We have seen already, right? But what you want, you have w_mara having 5 FEIT and 5, all these three values there, but you want to get update only this FEIT, not this 5 and this 5, MATNR and MBRSS at the second. So you just have to transport, means you are going to transport, you are going to modify only this material type. Okay, so you have to specify here transporting clause. You are telling to the system, please carry mTOR modification only, don't do anything else. Okay, so if you press F6, and now if you'll go into IT_mara, you can see only FEIT got changed over here. Still two is here. It didn't get changed anything at this particular place. But if you don't, would have given this one, no, as we have seen already, right? It would have changed everything at the second. At the second index, it would have kept everything 5 FEIT5. I will show once again and come over here, press F8, and come over here, and yeah, and this IT_mara, now go and check. You can see 5 FEIT and 5 is there, right? Everything got modified. So this is how you can use the transporting clause in order to modify some particular field. Okay, anything else? If you have any query, you can just keep, you can ask me. Okay, so transporting is fine. Anything else you want, Siva?
That one only.
Okay, good. So you understood, right? Or it's you want me to explain in more detail, more than this? I think it should be sufficient, right? Is it fine? Can you confirm? Can we go ahead? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. So now what we are going to do, you know, suppose if you are having some multiple entry in an internal table. Okay, let me prepare some, you know, same kind of entry, means duplicate entry. So I'm just going to prepare some duplicate entry over here. You know, I'm just copying and pasting over here. Okay, so I will get some duplicate entry. So now just save it and activate it, and at last we will see the final result over here. Okay, so here you will just get that in this IT_mara, now we are having 10 records, and out of these 10 records, there are many records which is duplicate. You can see this is the duplicate record, right? And here also you can see the duplicate record. Your requirement is now to remove the duplicate. So how we will do? It's very easy. If you're doing the programming in ABAP, it's very, very easy. So what you can do, that, you know, once your record got prepared, here your record got prepared, I'm just going to comment other thing. It's creating confusion. So what I will do that delete adjacent duplicates from IT underscore Mara and comparing all fields, whatever field you want to compare and do the deletion, that you can do over here. Okay, based upon the field comparison you can delete. Same as in Excel, right? You can select some field and based upon that you can compare and you can delete. So here I'm comparing all the field, so whatever the complete duplicate will be there, it will deleted. And now you can see only 4 records is there. Earlier it was 10 records and now again 4 records has come. Let me show you once again. IT underscore Mara is 10 right now, and once you press F6 it will become 4, right? All the duplicate got removed and only the unique is there. So this is how you can use. This is fine.
So this is comparing all fields. If any other field is also not matching, then again it will be there, right?
Right. Yes. Comparing all fields.
Okay.
Yeah. If you want to compare two fields only, you know, so you can just specify like this. Control D, comment, and comparing. Suppose if you want to compare only, you know, material field or material and MTR. So MATNR you can give, MTART you can give. Okay. So let's prepare some data like that. I will show you that part. Control C, Control V, Control V, Control V. And here, so FEIT here I will give you 5. Here I will give you 6. Sorry. 4, 5. It will be 4 only. And here it will be 6, it will be 4 only, and here it will be 7. Data got prepared, and come over here and we will run now. Press F8 and press once again F8, and you can see the currently IT underscore Mara is having 13 records. Okay, currently IT underscore Mara is 13 records here. This 444, right? FEIT. So wherever, you know, it is going to match only this, you know, this material and FEIT, it will just remove their duplicate. So instead of this 6 record, it will keep 1. Instead of this 5 record, it will keep again 1 record. Okay, and so 1, 1, 2, 3, 4 only you will be having the 4 unique record. Again you will be having only the 4 unique record. So you can just press F6 and you can see only 4 is there because other thing got removed. So like that, you know. And if you would have kept all the record, means if we're comparing all over here, then you know, just press F8 and you can see that IT underscore Mara is having 13 now. But if compare everything and press F6, you can see 7 is there. In 7 unique record is there if you are going to compare everything. Okay, but if you're just going to compare only MATNR and MTART, then again 3 records will be duplicate, right? This 3 4 4 4, FEIT, this what I prepared at last. Okay, so now that will also get, and now you are having the 4. So you can mention the field based upon your requirement. Okay, clear, refresh and free. Suppose if you want to clear work area, so you can use the clear. It will delete the content. If you want to refresh the content of, you know, if you want to refresh the content of internal table, okay, you can use the refresh IT underscore Mara. It will delete the content from there, right? Free. What is this free? Free, if we're going to use this free W underscore Mara and IT underscore Mara, okay, you can free the internal table, you can free the work area as well as internal table. Both you can free, means it will remove the allocated memory space. Okay, refresh will, let me show you the difference. Okay, so suppose this is your work area, okay, this is your work area. Okay, so if we're going to write clear WA underscore Mara, suppose name of the work area is W underscore Mara, what it will do, it will remove everything, allocated space, you know, allocated a memory, a space, content, everything, it will clear. Okay, so here I am wrong. It will delete the, see, whenever you define, whenever you write, you know, data wa underscore mara, type some structure you are going to give in ts something like mara, you know, then this wa underscore mara, you know, once you, it gets defined, it will allocate the memory space that is called extent, you know, extent. Initial memory space is known as extent. This is for definition purpose. And when you are going to store a value over here in w underscore mara, suppose some value you are going to store, let's suppose 1, 2, 3, whatever, then it will go, it will go and create the another memory space here. This is, you know, this I'm just forgetting, this memory space name is something called I don't remember exactly. So another memory space gets created, and if we're going to use the clear, what it will do, it will just remove the another memory space which is having the content, right? So here you are having the one, this one you have allocated over here, so this one is having over here, so just it will get removed, and the memory also get cleared. This memory also, this memory allocation will also get cleared. Okay, so this is what I'm trying to tell. This memory, suppose this memory is allocation, this also get cleared now, and it will be nothing over here, only initial extent will be there. But if we're going to use the drop this time, w underscore mara, what will happen, it will remove the initial memory allocation also, initial also, this extent also it will remove, you know, this extent also it will remove. I have written somewhere in PPT, let me check in the data dictionary slides. We are having this is actually, you know, so this is known as the initial extent, then the first extent, and then the second extent. This is how it is called. Okay, so here, you know, this is the initial extent, this is the first extent, right? It gets created. Okay, but when you are going to use the drop, everything will be, everything is going to vanish, everything will be cleared, content, memory allocation, everything. So that's the difference between clear and drop. If we're going to use the rephrase, so rephrase you can use only for the internal table. Okay, internal table, for internal table you can use rephrase, you can use the clear, both you can use for the internal table. Okay, but for work area you can use only the clear statement, wa underscore mara. You cannot use rephrase work area. Why you cannot use? Because in case of work area, you will be having initial extent, you know, you will be having the initial extent and the first extent only. Okay, initial extent and the first extent only will be having, because one record at a time you can store in a work area. You will never require to store more than one record. But in case of internal table, what will happen, you know, initial, like suppose if we're going to define this data it underscore mara type, you know, some ts underscore mara type table of, in fact, ts underscore mara, then in that case, as soon as you will define, it will create the initial extent over here, right? Initial extent, okay. So in case of it underscore mara also, it will create the initial extent. Okay, and this is the first extent, and suppose this extent is going to keep 5 records. So again, suppose in that internal table, suppose it comes something like 100 records, right? So again, it will have to create another extent to store the extra record, because in one extent it can store only 5 records, because internal table size can keep on increasing. So the number of extent also it will keep on increasing, right? So first extent, second extent, third and fourth extent, like that it will keep on coming, right? So what will happen, that if we're going to use the refresh over here, refresh it underscore mara, refresh, what it will do, refresh what it will do, it will remove the extra extent only, refresh, it will refresh the content, you know, it will refresh the contained memory as well from the first extent onwards. Okay, it will refresh the content. Suppose if you have some content 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever, it will remove everything, and it will remove the allocated memory space as well. Okay, so this is what refresh will do, and it will remove. This is not the case in the work area. This extra extent consent content extra content case is not there, so there is no need of using this refresh. Even if you are going to refresh work area, it will give you the error. Okay, it will give you the error because there is no extra extent, right? Because number of records is only one. Okay, number of record is only one. So but now again, if we're going to use the clear it underscore mara, right, what it will do, it will clear everything, initial extent also, it will, you know, the initial clear I'm going to use, right? Yes, so it will something I'm getting confused, just a second. Refresh, it will do it will erase the content, right? Drop everything, it will remove initial consent and all, right? Clear. So okay, fine. So this much now you understood, right? What is the difference between clear, what is the difference between drop, what is the difference between refresh and clear? Refresh you can use only for this it underscore mara, that means for internal table only, not for work area. If you will try, it will give you the error because it is not having the extra extent. Okay, so hope it's clear. And you know, for see, if we're going to use the refresh for work area, you know, it will give you the error. Check the syntax now, and you can see the statement refresh. Let me correct it. Refresh. Check the syntax, and you can see w underscore mara is not an internal table, right? So refresh can be used only for internal table, not for the work area. For work area, you can use only the clear statement. Okay, so refresh will erase the content, right, and remove the extra yes, and drop. So these are the different, you know, so refresh, free. Okay, so I was talking about the drop over here, that is not drop, that is the free. In case of here, it's a free. Okay, here it's a free. In database table we use the drop statement. So here free and there drop, both is same. Okay, here free and there drop, both is same. Okay, so free will remove everything, all the allocated space and everything. Okay, so fine, check the syntax now, and let me activate. So this is the difference between refresh, and this is very important interview question. Sometimes interviewer asks, what is the, though it's not very frequently asked, but sometimes they will ask you. Okay, why it's coming like this? Okay, come over here and we'll write the differences. That's not working. Let's write like this. So rephrase and clear. Okay, and maybe free also we can note it down here itself. Okay, so rephrase will, it will erase the content, simply erase the content, right? And what the clear will do, it will erase the content and extra, it will erase the content. Content means whatever the value, content means value. Okay, content means value, whatever you have given, 1, 2, 3, 4 or whatever, Ram Nam, whatever name and all, and extra extent. Okay, it will erase the content and extra extent. Okay, free, what it will do, it will erase the, you know, value plus extra intent, no, initial intent, intent extent, initial extent, actually intent extent, as well as initial extent also, as well as initial extent, everything it will erase. Okay, where extra extent is applicable, extra extent is applicable, you know, for the internal table only. Extra extent is applicable only for the internal table, right? Extra extent is not applicable for the, you know, extra extent is not applicable for work area, right? So rephrase can be used. So rephrase can be used for internal table, internal table, right? And the clear can be used, clear can be used only for work area. Okay, and the free, this free can be used for both, free can be used for both to release the memory, to release the memory. If you are not going to use the free, as soon as the program session is going to get terminate, automatically every variable and everything is going to get free. If you're not going to do after the program, everything is going to get released. But during the program, if you want to release the memory, you have to use the free statement. Okay, you'll have to use the free statement. Okay, so here also maybe I can just give a quick representation. So let's suppose, and this is the memory allocation. So this is when you are going to define the first one, the initial extent it will create, right? So I will just write here, this is your initial extent, initial extent, and this is your first extent, right? This is your first extent, and other thing, you know, other thing, all these things will come as the extra extent. Okay, after the first extent, second extent, third extent, fourth extent, like that you can tell, or you can tell that, you know, these are the different extent. Fine, hope it's clear now and you all are able to understand properly what I'm trying to make to understand over here. If you have any doubt, please feel free to ask. Okay,
can't we use a clear statement for internal table?
Yes, we can use. Clear can be used only for work area. Yes, work area, sorry, clear can be used for work area and internal table also can be used for work area as well as internal table and internal table both. Internal table both. Okay. Because here you can see it will erase the content value and extra extent both. Both capability is having with the clear statement. So clear can be used with work area and internal table both. Okay. Clear can be used. You can clear the internal table, you can clear the work area, but rephrase can be used only for the internal only for the internal table, not for the, you know, not for the work area. Okay, to erase the content, to erase the content here, whatever let's suppose a Matner you are having, and here mtart you are having, and some value you are going to keep it something like 1 roh, 2 roh, 3 feit, 4 feit. Okay, so this is how, what is the difference, the main difference you have to remember, that clear can be used for both, rephrase can be used for only one. Clear can be used for both and rephrase can be used for only for internal table. So this is what they want to listen from you. This content and all is a little more technical. If you're going to tell, he will become happy. Okay, but most of the time, 99.99% time, if we're going to tell this much only, this is the difference, he will be happy. You know, interviewer will get happy. He would try to listen, like what is the difference, the basic difference only. He would not like to go in advance. Maybe if with some experienced person, he would like to go in the advance, like this content and all, this concept what we have discussed. But for the experience, this is the important one. Just to remember this one. Okay, this much will be the sufficient. Okay, fine then. And let's quickly complete our internal table operation.
Hello.
Clear. Yes.
In programs for internal tables, which is recommended to use, which statement, free or refresh for internal tables?
Refresh.
Okay, thank you.
Mostly we are going to use the refresh. Free you have to use only when you are having some memory issue, right? In your, suppose your program is very big.
Yeah.
Depends on the scenario, you know. Suppose your program is very big and a lot of memory space has been consumed by the, you know, by the internal table definition. Suppose thousands of definition are there, which is unnecessarily consuming your memory space during the program. And you know that until and unless your program get finished, that memory space is not going to get released. In during the program itself, if you want to release your memory space, you can use the free statement and you can release this one. This, why we are not using so frequently this free, because while releasing the memory space, it may take little time, though that time will be very less, significantly very less, but still from performance point of view, maybe this refresh will work better, because it has to erase only the content. Free has to erase content plus initial extent plus extra extent plus memory allocation, everything it has to you know, everything it has to remove. So when you are required to release the memory space, you can go for this free when it is required. Otherwise, this free is sufficient. Okay, this free is sufficient. And
got it. Thank you.
Yeah, so here you can also use this clear statement for IT underscore Mara. This is internal table. You can check the syntax, right? You can see it is not giving any error, right? You can activate this one and you can even test it. Okay. So one question was there whether it will support or not. Yes, refresh and clear both will be supported. So IT underscore Mara is having 0 already, because I think somewhere we have refresh over here, right? So again, it will refresh, it will clear now. The memory, the extra extent will be cleared now with this clear statement. Initial extent is still there. Initial extent will be cleared only with the free statement. Okay. Yeah, please tell me.
Yeah, Pankaj, I have one.
Mm-hmm.
If, for example, if we Marcy table, there are key fields Matner and Works and same and take one more field data. Mm-hmm. Actually, mm-hmm. while sort, if we sort with the three fields, it will sort mm-hmm. and then only with based on that column, it will sorting.
Okay. I didn't get your question. Suppose you are having three column Matner, then MDOTs. Works.
And date, some year date.
Okay, year date you are having. Okay, now you
are I'm sorting record with these three fields. How it will sort? And based only these columns will sort or the entire record will sort?
Okay, good question. See what happens if you are having the standard table. Okay, if you are having the standard table, for example, you know, data you are having IT underscore tab type table of TS underscore Mara, type table of TS underscore Mara you are having, right? Here you are not specifying, system is not able to understand which is the key field, right? System does not understand which is the key field. If we're simply writing over here sort IT underscore tab, then what it will do, system will try to identify, suppose if we're fetching this record in this IT underscore tab, select Mara works from Marcy table. If we're going to fetch from the Marcy table, then you know in the Marcy table, this Mara and works is the key field. So IT underscore tab will assume that Mara and works is the key field, and it will implicitly sort based upon the this Matner, select Matner. So implicitly system will assume that Matner and works is a key field, and it will sort based upon that. Okay, so whatever it will understand the key field based upon that, by default it will sort. That's why, you know, that's why either while declaring the, you know, while declaring, like when you are going to give IT underscore Mara type table of TS underscore Mara, you can give the with unique key or with key. So that I will show you this thing here. You can come over here, and here, you know, here type table of ITS underscore Mara is there, right? So here you can write with unique key or with key or with table key. There is a syntax called table key or something like that, I don't remember. With key, let's suppose MATNR. Okay, so like that you have to define. So type a standard table of TS underscore Mara with key MATNR, and if you have some more keys, let's suppose if you want to give MTART, so explicitly we're going to give the, so this is the actually better practice if you want to, you know, don't want system explicitly decide what to do. Okay, what to do. So let me, I will show you in case of Matner itself on a single. So I will prepare some data which is in different format. Okay, so first I will put this 6 and one got missed. From where I copied 4, 5, 4, 6. Okay, no problem. I'll copy once again and I will paste it over here. Okay, so this is in unsorted order, and I will show you how it's going to be. Check this, activate this one, activate this, and now you can put the breakpoint over here. And let me write one sort statement first. Sort IT underscore tab, IT underscore Mara. This is simply we're giving sort IT underscore Mara. And you have given over here with key. If you have not given this with key, simply system, you know, system, whatever this Matner, you know, simply system is not able to understand what is the key field for you. So here implicitly how it is going to define, you are not sure. I'm also not sure how it's going to define. Okay, maybe it will consider Matner as a key field, right? So let's first see without key writing the with key. Activate this one, put the breakpoint on the sort, and we will see how it's going to behave. IT underscore Mara 15 records is there. You can see in beginning 6412 3344, it is there. It is in beginning, it is not sorted. Okay, so I'm just going to press F6 and let us see. It is got sorted. Yeah, you can see that 1 2 3 3 3. So implicitly what system does, you know, the first record it will consider as a, you know, it will consider as a key field, and it will sort based upon that, based upon the first record. Generally what it happens, based upon the first field it will does. Okay, so just to avoid such kind of things, you know, avoid such kind of confusion, you can give over here the, you can explicitly specify the sort IT underscore Mara by MATNR or sort IT underscore Mara by MTIT, you know, whatever the field you want to do, you can do. Or else explicitly here also you can give type standard table of TS underscore Mara with key. Suppose you based upon MTIT you want to, you know, sort. Okay, so where is that sort statement? Here, press F it. Okay, so now if you are here IT underscore Mara, you can see that, let me press F5, and you can see here I have just pressed F5, you know, I have just pressed F5, and you can see based upon, you know, MTRT have sorted, not for material. Why? Because, and at last ROH, so it has sorted based upon MTAR. So whatever the key field you have defined, based upon that it will, you know, sort. Or else it will take the first as a key field. It will implicitly consider as the first field as a key field. Okay, or else the better thing is that directly specify over here with what key field you want to sort it. There can be n number of scenarios, you know, you can just experiment on these things, you know, you can experiment. Even another scenario also you can experiment. There are n number of scenario you can get. Okay, let me quickly finish this one. This append lines of, or otherwise internal table operation also we will not be able to complete today. Okay, go to change, and so I'm just going to comment all these things now, and remove this, come over here. This is the append lines of, I will show you. Suppose if you have to append the line from one internal table to another internal table, so let's define one more internal table, IT underscore IT underscore. So I'm just going to define one more internal table, IT underscore Mara type table of TS underscore Mara. So another internal table I'm giving. I'm just going to prepare some data. Maybe I'm just going to prepare this data over here. Control V. So instead of IT underscore Mara, I'm just going to give IT underscore Mara one. So three records I prepared over here. Now all the record from IT underscore Mara one, I want to append into IT underscore Mara. So what you can do, IT underscore Mara one to IT underscore Mara, you can do like this. All the records will get appended. Okay, I will show you in the debugging, but let me first write for this also. Insert lines of, suppose if you want to insert the line. Okay, so for inserting, what you can do, if you have to insert lines of one internal table, let's suppose again IT underscore Mara one to IT underscore Mara, or let me declare one more internal table, IT underscore Mara two, and I will prepare some extra record, maybe some record over here. I will prepare 1 2 3 6 7 this 6, 7 only I'm just going to prepare. So where that got, yeah, come over here, control V, and it underscore Mara one, Mara one, that's fine over here. So it underscore Mara one, now I want to insert lines of it underscore Mara one to it underscore Mara. So here in case of insert, you have to mention the index. Okay, insert lines of to it underscore Mara from index, I think we'll have to give from index or whatever index you want to mention. I suppose from the third index you want to, or from the first index you want to insert, you can from index one to, let's suppose, 3. From index, let me check its syntax, I don't remember, press F1 and insert I tab. So in terms of lines of, actually I'm looking for lines, I tab result, insert, 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 leave this one. Okay, I will check this one. This is rarely used. Okay, this is rarely used, but still I wanted to show you index directly. It is not supporting insert lines of 2 into index 1. Yeah, actually I'm supposed to write into over here. Okay, so this is one, and another is move. Suppose if you want to just copy the content of one internal table into the another internal table, so what you can do, move it underscore Mara one to it underscore Mara. Okay, so if you want to simply copy the content from one table to another, so it will erase the existing content and it will copy. Another technique is also, you are having it underscore Mara, simply you can put in left hand side, and you in right hand side you can keep the it underscore Mara one. Okay, so it will get the content from here. Both will do the same thing. And then collect, we will discuss in detail tomorrow. It will take some time to understand the collect, very very important, this collect one. So tomorrow this collect we will see.
Pankaj, which one is passed in those three, move and append lines and undo and copy, which one is passed?
Every here you don't, you know, like this move or copy, both is going to have the same performance. It underscore Mara and this move, okay, both is going to have the same performance, there is no difference. Okay, and now I will just show you everything is now, I'll put the breakpoint over here, run. Okay, go to here and we'll see quickly. It underscore Mara one is having 5 records only, you can see, and it underscore Mara is having 13 records. Okay, so when we are going to insert the it underscore Mara one 5 records into this 13 records, total it will become the 18 records, 13 plus 5, 18 records. So press F6 and you will see 18 records has happened. So this is how, and at last it will get appended. All these 5 record will get appended at last from the it underscore Mara one. Okay, now whatever the it underscore Mara one, you are having only 5 records. Suppose if we're going to move from it underscore Mara one to it underscore Mara, what it will do, it will remove the record from it underscore Mara and it will copy the record from it underscore Mara one to it underscore Mara. Press F6 and you can see only 5 records is there, because in this it underscore Mara it has removed the earlier record. Okay, the same thing can be achieved by this way also. Okay, with this let's stop our today's session. It has been little longer today, sorry for that. You know, from tomorrow onwards we will try to keep as earlier, like 1.5 hour, like that, you know, or maximum 1.5 hour, not more than that, because the topic was little, you know, this internal table operation is also very important. And understanding is also very important, because this is the center of the SAP ABAP programming. That's where we are giving some more time, but this is still collect got left, and tomorrow we will understand detail in this collect statement. And then control, already you know, this loop and undo. Maybe I will explain this do and undo and while. Directly we will jump to this field symbol. This if else you already know, I believe, and we have been using many times this o if else and all these things. So explicitly no need to cover all these things, right? It will take a lot of time. So main thing is that to understand the concept. Okay, from the concept point of view, we are going to cover everything, you know, this for all entries, inner join, all these things we are going to cover in detail. Fine then. Okay, with this, let's stop our today's session, and I will just copy this one and I will paste it in a notepad. Okay, if you have any question, you can go ahead and you can ask any question if you have.
Oh, what is the difference between append and insert statements?
Okay, okay. In difference is that, you know, like append, it will append only at last. Okay, append will append only at last, but the insert you can specify the position. Okay, at which place it should insert, that you can specify the position with the help of insert, like at which place you have to insert the record. Append will only append at last. Is it clear, or shall I show you over here? Did you want to
yes it is clear, it is clear. Okay. Do we need to mention the index there?
Yes insert, yeah. Will not okay. Work without index. Okay,
okay,
it will
okay.
Give you in dump, it will go into dump. We have seen many times, right, that it was going into the dump. If you are not giving the somewhere here we have not giving any index with this insert. So whatever the delete statement, modify statement, and you know, a delete, modify and insert, we must have to specify the index. We must have to specify the index in case of delete, modify and insert. Okay, so I will just note it down, this one. So in a standard table, right, a standard table, we must have to specify the index at last for modify, insert and delete a statement. So we must have to specify the index at last, right? Either means explicitly or implicitly, right? Explicitly or implicitly. So explicitly means I have been using over here, like this is known explicit, means I'm mentioning myself, right? I'm mentioning myself, index one, index two. Here you can see this is called explicit. And here under the loop we have seen in detail how implicitly system takes the index. This index here I have explicitly mentioned, even I'm not going to mention this one, implicitly it will consider the current record index. So either you have to specify the explicitly or implicitly. So for implicitly how you can do, for implicitly you must have to use inside the loop. For implicitly you must have to use this operation inside the loop. And believe me that most of the time you are going to use this implicit one only, you know, in real time you are going to use inside the loop only. Okay, so this is the scenario, and hope it's clear now. And let me, if you have any doubt, anything else, if you have doubt, please go ahead and ask. No doubt, right? I'm just